shots and don't need a gun to get respect up on the street. Under the...
Hi, my name's Sabrina Spellman. I'm 60 years old, and I'm a half-witch. I live with my two aunts and our talking cat, Salem. Bow down, people of Earth! I am your supreme ruler. Ear scratches.
Es hora de comer. Es hora de comer.
Bum, bum, bum. Got any grapes?
Ew. Don't talk to me. Ugh.
Rose had enough room on the door for Jack. There is no possible way. I just feel like if she really loved him, she would have had enough room for him. This is the most emotional movie I've ever seen, and that just makes me so sad.
A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta. Thumbs up, elbows back, feet apart, knees together. A tootie ta, a tootie ta, a tootie ta ta.
Hi, my name is Katie, spelled K-A-T-I-E with no Y, because Y's are L.
My name is Becky, spelled B-E-C-K-I-E with no Y, because Y's are L.
Today is very special because it is my 18th birthday, and we're going to have a sleepover.
Anyways, girl, why did you make me wear this mask to your party?
Haven't you heard? There's just like this L thing going around called Corona.
Corona? I hate beer. Ew.
Seriously?
What?
Never mind.
Anyways, girl, who wanted you invite to this thing?
You know I had to invite my girl Peggy.
Peggy? She's so ew. Why do you keep inviting her to these things? Anyways, who else did you invite? Maybe they'll make up for her.
I don't know if I can tell you.
Come on, it can't be that bad.
I don't think I can tell you.
It's gonna be fine, just as long as it's not.
Hey, girlies. My name is Jackie, spelled J-A-C. What is she doing here? I thought we talked about this.
What did you just talk about?
Well, she told me not to invite you over, especially after y'all's little situation.
And you said yes? I can't stand you. I hate you. You are both so ew. Don't call me. Don't text me. I hate you both.
Hey, girlies. Why is Becky crying?
No time to explain. Peggy with a Y, spelled P-E-G-G-Y.
Ew.
We have to go get her.
Here's girl. Okay.
I wanted to sit you down today to let you know that I hate you. I'm not the hateful type, but I can make an exception for people like you. You think you're pretty smart, right? The ultimate mastermind, more like a masquerader, hiding behind the white man because you afraid of me, you afraid of my potential, the things that I could become if I learned how to overcome you. Don't you understand that my pain is prolonged by your actions? You've orchestrated this game called America and divided us into factions. You've caused mass hysteria, and now look at what remains. You've concealed our culture and told us to change, told us to talk like you, told us to walk like you. You chastise us for being what you hate, the black man, the blueprint, the thing that them bats and blue badges fear. It's almost so insane how they see us. Awesome. Why guys want to do is be us. And they tell us our diction and behavior is unruly and egregious. It's so insane how they see us. Awesome. White men want to do is be us, and they love putting blackface on everything but Jesus. I wonder if you would ever love me, because I could never love you, sir. You're the reason that my peers grow up wanting to pass the rock around, either on the basketball courts or them trap houses. You're the reason I can't cast my hood up on my head like the Reaper y'all see me as when I walk into the corner store. You're the reason that my brothers murder each other over the same medicine that you put into our silky neighborhoods in the first place. You're the reason that my brothers die, murdered in the street, body lifeless and cold as the barrel of the gun that touched their abdominal, magazine getting empty like pages ripped out of a Rolling Stone issue, with the only clips remaining were the ones plastered all over CNN. Hashtag Black Lives Matter. Tell me who declared you God. Who told you you could choose who lives and who dies, who prospers and who falls within the cracks of your unforgiving palms? You're no God. You're a mere concept, not even a mortal, an idea that has been encapsulated in a conversation of oppression against African Americans in this country. I want you to know, sir, that I'm not afraid of you anymore. I've came into myself and I realized who I am. I am a king, a black man with hair that grows an infinite number, with skin that is kissed by the sun, with a stature and swagger that none of your other minions could attain. I am a king with a culture and lifestyle that is imitated by many, with a prolific profile of strength and resilience passed down by my ancestors who were beaten and botched. I am a king who will teach my brothers how to break you, how to sift you as wheat, and how to divide and conquer across this country. I am a king, and most importantly, unapologetically black. I'll wear my chains until my neck falls off. I'll speak that slang until my tongue falls off. I'll throw up that fist until my hands falls off. I am not your Negro. I choose my own destiny. I choose. Look, I'm sorry. It's already bad enough that y'all see me as an angsty thug. I'll make sure to go pick up my Popeyes today, and I'll make sure to apply for a job, then opt to sell jokes anyway because I know y'all won't call back. I'll make sure to tell my beautiful black niece that she should be ashamed of her body and her hair, even though when she grows up, some of her white peers will try to seem exactly like her. I'll make sure to beg for sympathy when my friend, a black kid, gets shot, but then realize because of the one time he committed petty theft, it makes him a no-good criminal that deserved to die anyways. Please excuse me for my aggression. I'm sorry for acting this way. Forgive me, Mr. Racism. Thank you for sitting down with me today. Have a blessed night.
Some place to go. Life's a taste, yes, but you go toe-to-toe. You don't give up, no, you grow. And you use your pain, cause it makes you you. I wish I could hold you through it, but it's not the same. You got living to do, and I just want you to do it. So get up, get out, relight that spark. You know the rest by heart. Wake up, if it's all you do. Look out, look inside of you. It's not your loss, it's what you'll gain. Raising your voice to the rain. Wake up, your dream, and make it true. Look out, look inside. Know what you lost. Realize that spark. Time to come out of the dark. Wake up. Ooh, wake up. Better wake those demons. Just look them in the eye. No reason not to try. Life can be a mess. I won't let it cloud my mind. I'll let my fingers fly. And I use the pain, cause it's part of me, and I'm ready to power through it. Gonna find the strength, find the melody, cause you show me how to do it.
Behold, I am the genie of the lamp.
Whoa, it's a magic man.
That's a genie, you dumb butt.
Who robbed my lamp?
I didn't do it. He did.
I did?
I knew I shouldn't have rubbed that lamp.
It was a dare. You didn't have to do it.
Wait, are you saying he didn't rub my lamp?
No, he definitely did.
But you just said you did, and I really need to know who rubbed my lamp. It's a very crucial part.
Why?
Because I need to know who to give the wishes to.
Wishes?
Yeah, that's common knowledge.
Well, then I rubbed your lamp.
No, I did.
But I found it!
Stop! How about this? I give each of you one wish. How does that sound?
Yeah, let's do it!
Acceptable!
Good. We'll start with you. What do you want?
I wish. for 47 wheels of cheese.
Your wishes, wait. Why do you want 47 wheels of cheese?
Don't question my wishes, man.
Okay. Spot done. Go.
Okay, me next.
Okay, what would you want?
So, I want the tallest person in my class to be shorter. Like, I'm great in my height and all, but I want him to be shorter.
Are you sure you don't want to be taller?
Shut up!
Okay, it's done.
Sweet.
Now you, what do you want?
I want you to thaw off my porch.
Really? That's it?
Yep, I'm tired of doing it every single year.
How about instead I give you the ability to thaw out your own porch? How's that sound?
No, that will not be necessary. Please.
Fine. It's granted. Leave me.
Thank you!
Jeez. I swear, with every passing person, these wishes get dumber and dumber.
Yo, sweet! A genie went! Now I get that new plunger!
Ah!
No, genie, wait up!
I once read a book on anti-gravity, and let me tell you, I could not put that thing down.
Things first. Have you adjusted your mirrors?
Yes, all three of them, and I can see myself perfectly.
They are not for vanity. They're for your rear. Now you're behind. Behind you.
But I won't be able to see myself having fun.
Driving a motor vehicle isn't about having fun. It's serious business. Have you adjusted your seatbelt?
I was going to, but this outfit just wrinkles so easily, and so I thought...
Just do it.
But my outfit!
It's the law. Okay, now, are you familiar with the gear shift?
You mean the Prindle?
The what?
The Prindle.
Are you referring to the shift lever that says P-R-N-D-L?
I'm not a child, Mosby. I know how to spell Prindle.
It isn't something you spell. It is a gear shift. The letters stand for park, reverse, neutral, drive, LO!
You're making me nervous with all this technical talk.
Oh, I'm sorry. Why don't we just relax? Turn on the radio. Would you like am or foam?
We're all unique, like a snowflake. There are many imperfections that we don't see. We bury them down to the depths of the sea. We cover them up, those scars that bleed, the same color red in you as in me. Different traumas bringing different pain, but deep down we're all individually the same. So, on those lonely nights whenever you can't sleep, when you look in the mirror calling yourself ugly, and whenever you can't see your own beauty, just remember, you are unique, my fellow snowflake.
I ain't ever seen two pretty best friends.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Don't tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Don't tell
no.
No. Oh. I see how it is. Rapunzel knows best. Rapunzel's so mature now, such a clever grown-up miss. Rapunzel knows best. Fine, if you're so sure now, go ahead and give him this.
How did you?
This is why he's here. Don't let him deceive you.
I need a bad bleep, Addison Rae, Lil Shawty the Baddest, yeah, and she got her ways. So the lyrics are very heartfelt to me because I'm Addison Rae.
Why did the photo get arrested? It was framed.
Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated!
Pizza, pizza.
I love Nestle Crunch.
Peel the avocado, peel the avocado, peel the avocado, peel the avocado. Guac a mole, guac guac a mole, guac a mole, guac guac a mole.
It's a beautiful day to be a neighbor. A beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day to be a neighbor. Won't you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Today is going to be such a great day to... I wonder who that could be.
Good morning, Mr. Rogers.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Rogers.
Good morning.
If you've got the time, we'd love to ask you a few questions.
I love questions. There's a wanted criminal in the neighborhood, but we can't seem to find where he lives. Interesting.
He goes by the name Vincent Rocco, but we believe he may be using an alias.
Never even heard of him. Well, if you have any more information for us, please make sure to let us know. Okay. Have a good day.
Hopefully we'll see you soon, Mr. Rogers.
You too.
Have a good day, Mr.
You
Rogers.
You too. Okay. Today's going to be such a wonderful day today. We're going to have someone come learn with us. Her name is Mrs. Longington. That must be her. Hey, Mrs. Longington, how was your day?
My day was great, and how was yours?
Amazing, but now since you're here, we can learn about the word of the day, tax evasion. Miss Longington here loves tax evasion.
Sure do.
See, tax evasion is when you avoid paying taxes. I commit tax evasion every day.
I've got you now.
Huh?
Freeze, you're in arrest
for tax evasion. I'm innocent.
No need to lie. I told them everything.
You snitch.
I'm an undercover cop, and you're going away for a very long time, Mr. Rogers. Or should I say Vincent Rocco?
Get him out of here. Remember, kids, if you can't do the time, then don't do the crime.
I can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice I'm not. Just a mirror. You check your complexion to find your reflections all alone. I had to go. Can you hear me? I'm not coming home. Do you understand? I've changed.
New York City, I never sleep while I Duncan. Little surprised to see you here.
Why? We've talked about cheerleading before.
Yeah, I remember that conversation. You told me you'd try out for cheerleading if you dropped, 50 IQ points.
Listen, I say some crazy things. I have so much respect for cheerleading now. I've seen Bring It On, like, twice?
And this has nothing to do with our big trip coming up, does it?
You're taking a trip? Oh my god, this is the first time hearing of this.
Uh-huh, okay. Well, let's see what you got. Hit it.
Woo! 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 Go Rams!
If there's a prize for rotten judgment, history, but you're dying to cry.
My turn. I make this look easy. To boom like gasoline. If they call me Lamborghini, cause I know just what I'm worth. Zero to 100, but my body make them stutter. Stop my engine, push the button. I'm gonna be coming first. Yeah, I'm a machine when I do it. I'll be catching fire, gasoline when I do it.
Well, it looks pretty solid to me. On 5-inch titanium screws.
Excellent. Are we done here?
Yeah, I just gotta get the, Drake?
What?
Where is the door hole?
It's right where I drew with the magic marker thingy.
You were supposed to cut it out with a power saw.
Dude, I'm going to.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Then go get the saw.
I will. I see your point.
Oh, do you?
So, how are we going to get out?
Megan! Megan!
Come down, I'm bringing your screws.
No, I need you to bring up the power saw.
Why?
Because Drake forgot to cut the hole for the door, and now we're trapped.
Oh my gosh, this is the greatest thing that can ever happen.
Megan, would you just bring up the power saw right now?
Nah, I don't think I will.
Come on! We have to meet our dates in 2 hours! And they're hot twins!
So what? I missed Jamie's birthday party. Now you two can miss your dates. No twins for you?
Megan, bring up the saw right now.
Nah, I'm gonna go get myself a snow cone.
Megan!
Oh, I bid farewell to the port and the land. I paddle away from brave England's white sands to search for my long ago forgotten friends, to search for the place I hear your sailors end. As the souls of the dead fill the space of my mind, I'll search without sleeping till peace I can find. I fear not the weather, I fear not the sea. I remember the fallen, do they think of me? When their bones in the ocean forever will be.
Hey, have you eaten today? Have you drank water? Have you taken a break? No? Why? Here, have some water. Please take care of yourself. Go get a snack, drink some water, take a break. And remember, I care about you.
Becky, wait!
No! Not with her here!
Not after what she did!
What did she even do?
I had a plan to ask Kurt Hennessy to prom. It was a band and confetti, and all I needed was a distraction. But her idea of a distraction was to ask him to prom!
It's okay. I see the problem. Why did you ask Kurt to prom?
I was just trying to distract him. He asked me. It's all his fault the situation so ill.
But you didn't say no!
I just want to be like you for change. You're just so perfect and on. You get all the cute guys.
You're right. I am perfect. And I do always get the cute guys. You deserve to be with someone sweet for once. I can't find another date.
Aww. So, like, are y'all okay now?
Yeah.
Well, let's go party. Spelled P-A-R-T-I-E with no Y, because Ys are ew.
Let's go.
Ys are not ill.
So you want to know what makes America the greatest country in the world? Fine. Sharon, the NEA is a loser. Yeah, it accounts for a penny out of her paycheck, but he gets to hit you with it anytime he wants. It doesn't cost money, it costs bolts and airtime and column inches. And seriously, with a straight face, you're going to sit up here and tell all these students that America is so star-spangled awesome that we're the only ones in the world that offer freedom? Canada has freedom. Japan has freedom. The UK, France, Italy, Germany, Spain, Australia, Belgium even has freedom. So to like 207 sovereign states, 180 of them have freedom. And you, sorority girl, just in case you happen to wander into a voting booth one day, there's a few things you should know. And one of them is there is absolutely no evidence to support the claim that we are the greatest country in the world. We're 7th in literacy, 27th in math, 22nd in science, 49th in life expectancy, 178th in infant mortality, number 3rd in median household income, number 4 in labor force, and number 4 in exports. We lead the world in only 3 categories: number of incarcerated citizens per capita, number of adults who believe angels are real, and defense spending. where we spend more than the next 26 countries combined, 25 of whom are allies. Now, none of this is the fault of a 20-year-old college student, but you, nonetheless, are without a doubt part of the worst generation period ever, period. So when you ask what makes America the greatest country in the world, I don't know what you're talking about.
So, what do you do with a dead chemist? You bury him.
Side boogie, press play. Yeet, yeet, skirt. Yeet, yeet, skirt, skirt, skirt. Roll up.
Yeet,
drop that.
Yeet,
skirt that.
Yeet,
hop that.
Yeet.
Ay, 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 ay.
You never loved me, Mom, but I needed you. Oh, oh.
Baby. Shark, do 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 do, baby shark, do do.
Boo!
Baby shark. Oh yeah. Oh, it's an avocado. Thanks.
Roar, roar, Raggy.
I am stuck on Band-Aid brand, 'cause Band-Aid's stuck on me.
Spencer and Callahan's in one to see. Call 3872323.
Did you hear what Gerald did?
Girl, I did not. What
he did on me with lead.
Oh, what are they wearing?
Yikes.
Ugh. What's that? A hat? A crazy, funky, chunky hat, hair slightly, trying to look like Keira Knightley. We've been there, we done that, we see right through your funky hat.
I fell by the wayside. Like everyone else, I hate you, I hate you, I hate you, but I was just kidding myself. Now every moment I start to replay, and now all I hear are the words that I needed to say. When you hurt under the surface, like troubled water running cold, well, time can heal, but this won't. So, before you go. Was there something I could have said to make your heart beat better? If only I had known you had a storm to weather. So before you go, was there something I could have said to make it all stop hurting? It's crazy how your mind can make you feel so worthless. So before you go.
I'm tired of fighting. Fighting alone. Fighting without my friends. Fighting without my phone. Fighting to stay alive and to feel loved. Fighting an endless war of never being enough. Am I asking too much, wanting to be seen? Am I asking too much for you to love me?
Excuse me, where are you going?
I'm going on stage.
And where are your shoes at, honey?
They're right here on my feet.
All right, where's your necklace at?
Give me that, right here, stupid.
Okay. You need to stop walking off before I tell you, because it's really getting aggravating.
Aw, I guess we have that in common.
Excuse me?
I used to be afraid of hurdles, but I've been getting over them.
I have a long-term settlement, and I need cash now. Call J.G. Wentworth. 877 cash now. I have a long-term payment and I need cash now. Call JG Wentworth. 877 cash now. 877 cash now. 877 cash now. 877 cash now. Call JG Wentworth. 877 cash now.
Hi neighbor, be a money saver. Hi, neighbor. Oh, oh, oh. O'Reilly. O'Reilly AutoZone. Thank you. That was dyslexic. Slogan, sing it.
Chuck E. Cheese's. Where a kid can be a kid.
What am I supposed to do with this? Okay.
Hey, my name is Bubbles from the Powerpuff Girls. The blue one. You might think I'm sweet, but I can actually be hardcore.
My fairy grandma warned me Cinderella's story on the end. The prince ain't sleeping when he takes his sleeping beauty to the motel on his Snow White horse. So call me a pessimist, but I don't believe in it. Finding a true love's kiss is cool. Cause I feel sad, I feel bad, sometimes happy love turns into giving up.
I'm sorry, and I think this is yours.
And I'm Jessie, and this is just my slingshot.
You don't know it's a bra. Bye, nanny. Whatever your name was. Hey, Jessie, wanna be my new nanny?
Oh, I'm sorry, sweetie, but I didn't come all the way from Fort Hutton, Texas to become a babysitter. I came to New York to follow my dreams, and this is where dreams come true.
Yeah. Whatever. Until then, I like my grilled cheese cone triangles and my tutu starched.
I remember my days of wanting to sneak into girls' parties.
Oh, come on, Mr. Gary. You know it's not like that.
Uh-huh. Sure it isn't. You crazy kids have fun, though.
Kit, what are you doing here?
Look, I just wanted to come to apologize to you guys.
Oh? I'm waiting.
Why did my dad let you in the house?
Well, I couldn't take Jackie to prom in good conscience, knowing that Becky was going to ask.
No!
Yes! What are you doing here?
I can't take you either, Becky.
What? Why?
Wait, how did you know Becky was gonna ask you?
I told him. I didn't want to see my girlies fight, so I told him to come solve the problem.
Oh, Peggy.
Well, after Peggy told me that, I couldn't do that to you guys. But after I saw how sweet and caring Peggy was,
yeah.
I decided that I was gonna go to prom with Peggy.
Ah!
Ah! Oh, I'm so excited for you, Peggy.
I'm so happy for you, man.
But now neither of us have dates.
You don't even have to worry about that, all right? I got twin cousins coming in from LSU because they're spring break. They would definitely go with you guys.
All right, perfect, girlies, but where should we go eat?
Look, I know this great place called Sushi Town. I love the raw tuna.
Yeah! Get out of here!
And I present free thoughts on the proceedings of the Continental Congress. Heed not the rabble who scream revolution, they have not your interest at heart. Chaos and bloodshed are not a solution, don't let them lead you astray. This Congress does not speak for me, they're playing a dangerous game. I pray the king shows you his mercy. For shame, for shame.
Yo,
heed not the rabble who scream
but the revolution,
they have not your interest at heart.
Listen to you with a straight face.
Chaos and bloodshed are not a solution, don't let them lead you astray. This Congress does not speak for me,
speaks more eloquently than
they're playing a dangerous game.
Your mange is the same.
I pray the king shows you his mercy.
Jersey,
for shame.
Yourself again, I'm gonna
scream.
Honestly, look at me, please.
Not your interest.
Don't modulate the key, then not debate with me. Why should
I?
I'd rather be divisive.
You say the price of my love's not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. Remember despite our estrangement, I'm your man. You'll be back, soon you'll see. You remember you belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. You say our love is draining and you can't go on. Change the subject, 'cause you're my favorite subject, my sweet, submissive subject, my loyal, royal subject, forever and ever. back like before. I will fight the fight and win the war for your love, for your praise. And I'll love you till my dying days. When you're gone, I'll go mad. So don't throw away this thing we heard. Cause when push comes to shove, I will kill your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Everybody, da 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 da.
This is Cyrus Conley.
This is Caleb Bradford. We're from Joseph McJackets. Thank you for watching the variety show on DSTV.